I am completely and utterly thrilled to be welcoming all of you here today for the beginning of what I think is going to be a history-making journey together and an exceptional education for all of you. I can tell you in all honesty that there has never, ever been a better time to be joining the field of public health.
Dynamic, compelling, integrated.
I'm attending one of the best institutions for public health.
I never worked as hard as I did last semester. I also have never learned as much.
Our students are going to lead the world. They're going to lead our country. They're going to lead our state. They're going to lead our city in creating health for all of us.
We did not tweak. We radically changed about 50% of the courses that we offer our master's students. I think it would be an absolutely great experience to go back in time and be a master's student in this new reimagined curriculum.
Our students are going to leave here with great disciplinary skills and the ability to work in interdisciplinary teams. They, are being challenged at a much higher level than ever before, and much to our delight, they are living up to expectations and showing us that they are able to meet those challenges and even exceed them.
In the cohorts, I was able to make friends with people that were in a lot of different departments, and I'm still friends with them now. So that's been really helpful, I'm in the epidemiology department, and not just being friends with people in epidemiology and using their skills and their expertise, but also seeing people that are interested in social aspects of health.
This is the first time that we've really tried to combine the principles of epidemiology and the principles of biostatistics into one class to really show students how these two disciplines work together, as we often do when we actually practice public health science.
Our new core curriculum differs in myriad ways from a traditional core curriculum in content, in goals, and even in the delivery.
The professors here are very passionate about what they do and what they teach, and definitely you can see that passion come through and that conviction they have about the subject while they teach.
I chose Columbia because of the core, especially how broad the topics were, and at the same time they were really integrated.
How are we going to get this approved? Who are we going to go to get this approved? How can we design this study ethically so we can do this?
One of the things that I think is really exciting about the integration of science and practice from a teaching standpoint as well as from a student standpoint is that it brings together students from across the different departments. And just as they'll have to do when they go into the real world, the environmental health scientists are working with the socio-medical scientists, with the epidemiologists, in a way that they can then integrate, have an integrated approach to solving public health problems.
Challenging innovation and integration, these are the most important things that we're learning here, I think.
Because I think a lot of the things that we do in school are very focused on the academic components, and this is actually gives us more of a way to apply them, and so we kind of put the what we learn in school to real life problems.
The faculty does some amazing research all around the world, and as a global certificate student, I have had the opportunity to learn from people like Margaret Crook, who's in sub-Saharan Africa doing research projects and program evaluation. I'm able to learn from some of the professors who are top in their field.
The faculty is really amazing. They're accessible. They are very into helping their students learn.
I think what is remarkable about this place is that it is a school with a tremendous depth of history, but that still has the will and the energy to launch a creative new project like this one. I think it's unusual to be in an institution that is both old and well established, but still has the vigor to attempt bold, innovative efforts like this one.
Academic public health leaders know, we all know, that public health education has to evolve with the times. The 21st century demands are different than the 20th century demands. There's no question that innovation is critical.